Hello everyone, welcome back to OCM's lecture, and today we are going to learn about more about types of banks. Okay, till now we are done with three types of banks. Yeah, in that central bank, then commercial bank and cooperative bank, right? We are done with central bank. Yes, it is the apex bank. It is it was RBI bank, okay? And commercial bank, which are there for profit motive, where people can deposit their money and take loan from there, okay? Like SBI, okay? And cooperative banks are the bank which are there for service motive, which are there to give services to people, right? Services to people, right? So today we're going to learn about industrial development bank. Okay, this is the fourth type which we are going to learn today. Yes, first one was central, then commercial, then cooperative, and now central development bank. Okay, so central development bank is basically the bank, as the name indicates, industrial development bank, as the name indicates, industrial development. Yes, industrial development means which are there for industries, which are there for industrial development, like providing them, like providing industries money or services or equipments, we can say machinery or money for development, for growth, for expansion of the business. See, for expansion of the business, industry needs money, and that money for expansion, for modification, for growth is provided by industrial development bank. Okay, so let us see. Yes, as you can see it on your screen, industrial development bank business often requires medium and long term capital. Yes, of course, for the betterment of the industry, for the growth, for the modification, for expansion, for opening new branches, industry needs money. What is given on the screen? Business often requires medium and long term capital for purchase of machinery, equipment, for using latest technology, or for expansion and modification. Right? As I told you, for using latest technology, as we can say, for using new machinery, which is according to the new technology, what industry needs? It needs money, and that money is provided by industrial development bank. Yes, business often requires medium and long-term capital for purchase of machinery, equipments, for using latest technology. Whatever technology is there, see, if industries won't be using latest technology and some other industry will use that technology, of course our customer will shift to that products which are giving them new features, like for mobile phones. Yes, we cannot, our company cannot rely on or depend on mobile which are having old features or which are not having any new feature. Yes, like Nokia phone, Nokia black and white phone, very few people purchase it now, right? Why? Because they are getting latest technology, then why will they purchase old technology? So for being in the market, to be in the market, to compete with the competitors, what industry needs to do? It has to use latest technologies, right? By using latest technology, industries can compete in the market, can survive in the market, yes? Or for expansion and modification, yes, to grow our business, to open new branches, what industries need? It needs money, and that money will be provided by industrial development banks. Yes, what is given next? Such financial assistance is provided by development banks, yes, for purchasing those machinery, equipment, latest technology. The help, assistance means help. Help is provided by development banks, yes. The functions of development bank are provision of medium and long term funds to business unit for purpose of expansion and modification. Yes, what is given here now, that development banks, IDBI we can say, industrial development bank, provides funds, yes, for expansion and modification. Yes, provision for medium and long term funds. Yes, it provides medium and long term funds. Medium funds means for 1 to 5 years, and long term funds means beyond 5 years, more than 5 years. Yes, so IDBI or Industrial Development Bank provides medium and long-term finance to industries, yes. Next is underwriting of shares issued by public limited companies. Yes, underwriting of shares. I'll show you on the board. Then purchase of debentures and bonds, yes. Yes, so we learned three features here. Sorry, functions. We learned three functions here. First one was medium and long term funds. Yes, second one was very important, underwriting of shares. And third one was purchasing debentures, yes. Okay, so first function was medium and long term funds. Yes, as I told you, medium term loan is for 1 to 5 years, between 1 to 5 years, yes. And long term fund is more than 5 years. Okay, so Industrial Development Bank of India, yes, it provides medium and long term funds to business, to for purchasing machinery, for purchasing equipments, or for purchasing latest technology, yes. Second one was very important, underwriting of shares, yes. Underwriting of shares here means suppose the target is to sell 1,000 shares. Yes, the target is selling of 1,000 shares. of ABC company. Yes, I'll rub this. Underwriting of shares. Yes. The target was of ABC company to sell 1,000 shares. Yes, but share sold was only 8,000. Only 8,000 was sold. So what about this 2,000? Yes, so this 2,000 will be purchased by Industrial Development. Okay, Industrial Development Bank. Yes, so like target was to sell 1,000 shares. Yes, for, as you know, share capital. Whatever money comes from shares, that is known as share capital. You know this, yes? So, target of ABC company was to sell 1,000 shares, but at the end, shares sold was only 800. Yes? So, difference is of 200. Difference is of 200 shares. So, what about this 200? Company is in loss now. So, this 200 will be purchased by Industrial Development Bank. As you know that Industrial Development Bank provides finance. Yes, if Industrial Development Bank is purchasing these 200 shares, of course, Industrial Development Bank is giving money to ABC Limited. Yes, so indirectly or directly we can say Industrial Development Bank is giving funds to ABC Limited. Yes, so this is the second function of Industrial Development Bank. That, see, this 2000 shares is known as underwriting of shares. Okay, so this is the function of Industrial Development Bank, that it also purchase, we can say, the unsold shares. Okay, public who did not purchase shares or remaining shares will be purchased by Industrial Development Bank. In this way also, Industrial Development Bank will provide finance to company, to industries. Okay, so this was the second function. Again, I'm telling you, target was to sell 1,000 shares, but actual share sold was only 800. Yes, remaining was 200. 200 shares were unsold. Yes, so these unsold shares was purchased by Industrial Development Bank, and in that manner, Industrial Development Bank will provide finance to ABC Limited. Yes, in the same manner, third point was debentures. Same manner, company Industrial Development Bank will purchase debentures of the ABC Limited. Yes, first function was providing medium and long term loans of funds. Second was underwriting of shares. Then third was purchasing debentures. Yes, means they directly provide medium and long term funds, then underwriting of shares means Industrial Development Bank purchase unsold shares. Yes, and it also purchase debentures of the company. Yes, by this manner, Industrial Development Bank helps industries to develop. As the name says, Industrial Development Bank means bank for industries development. Yes. Let's see what are the industrial development banks. We'll see the example of industrial development banks. Yes. Hope you all watching the videos, students. You have only 6 months left for your board exam, so start studying. Yes, we learned about functions of development banks. Now we'll learn examples of development bank, that is Industrial Finance Corporation of India and State Financial Corporation. Yes, these are the industrial banks which help industries to develop. Yes, so next one is, we can say we are done with four types of banks. Now we'll learn fifth type of bank, that is exchange bank. Yes, so what are exchange bank? Exchange bank are mainly concerned with financing foreign trade. Yes, as the name indicates, exchange means, of course, exchanging currencies or import export, we can say, or a bank which helps in foreign trade. Yes, so what is given here? Exchange bank are mainly concerned with financing foreign trade. Yes, main function of exchange bank are, first one is remitting money from one country to another. As the as you know that we learned many a times about remitting. Remitting means transfer. Yes, so first function of exchange bank is it transfers money from one country to another country. Okay, second is discounting of foreign bills. Yes, you know that bill of exchange, if you are purchasing something from one company, if you don't have money, you'll give them bill of exchange, and that seller can go there and discount their bill of exchange. You know about it, you have learned it in your 11th. So second function is discounting of foreign bills. Suppose import export is there. Importer has given a bill of exchange to importer. So importer will go to exchange bank and discount that bill of exchange. Yes. Third one is helping import and export trade. Yes. It also helps import and export trade, for exporting or for importing. What are formalities are there for exchanging currencies? Exchange bank helps in import and export trade also. Yes, next one is remittance of dividend, interests and profit. Yes, dividend, interest and profit is also given by exchange banks. And last one is issue letter of credit. Suppose A is a purchaser and B is a seller. Yes, so A is giving letter of credit to B. A is not having money, so A is giving letter of credit to B. So that letter of credit is also issued by exchange bank. In short, we can say exchange bank is, as it is given here, it is there for financing foreign trade. As we learned, it helps in remittance money from one country to another country. Discounting of bills, bill of exchange, discounting of foreign bills. Yes. Third one is helping import and export trade also. Then fourth one is remittance of dividend, interests and profit. And fifth one is issue letter of credit. Yes. Example is Bank of Tokyo and Bank of America. Okay, children. So today we learned about fourth and fifth type of banks. Yes, fourth one was Industrial Development Bank. Then Exchange Bank. So till now we are done with five types of banks. Industrial Development Banks are the bank which helps industries to develop. It provides them money. Its function is to provide medium and long-term finance and underwriting of shares and purchasing of debentures. It helps industries to develop. It helps them to purchase new equipments, machinery, new technology. Yes. And Exchange Bank are the bank which helps in foreign trade, in financing foreign trade. Yes, its function is to transfer money from one country to another country. Yes, issuing letter of credit, discounting bills of exchange, foreign bills of exchange. Yes, and it also helps in import and export. Yes, so students, today we learned about five types of bank till now, and in next lecture we'll learn about more about banks, regional rural development banks and investment banks, saving banks. We will learn about it in a next lecture. Okay, so students, hope you are learning it, you are watching the videos. Please watch the video, it is for your betterment. Due to this pandemic, we are not able to attend normal classes as we used to do it in your 11th. Yes, so only 6 months are left for your board exam. So study hard, children, and stay home and study.